Hi folks, welcome to the next lesson. What we're going to be looking at today is we're going to be looking at the palm heel strike and the actual scratch system. Let's start off with the palm heel. Right, if you look at the picture just here, you can see a close-up of my actual hand. And what it is it shows you exactly how and where the actual strike points are and where your hands have to be. Your fingers and your thumb locking down. Make sure that thumb's locked all the way down because that's what locks the wrist. Right? Just like with the punch, you need to lock your wrist out to make it an actual a lever point. So let's do it together. We're going to use it from here, again from this position here. We're just going to push forward, straight in. Push forward, straight in. You notice my legs are flexing slightly. Push forward, straight in. This gives you an extra couple of inches to push through. This would be aimed at the nose and the actual lower part of the chin, or even the forehead, just to push the head back. So, forehead, nose, chin. There's also another technique that you can use with the palm heel, which is underneath the chin. This is usually when you're actually coming in close, and there's about 21 inches gap between the two of you, and you just come straight up. And it just goes straight up underneath the jaw here. Right? The second technique, which we'll go into in a moment, that you can do from that. But let's just practice that. So you're in here, it's coming up and out. It's coming up and out. Again, it's from this back leg. This is your lever point. A lot of taijutsu is based on your legs, giving you the power. It's nothing about the power, the big muscles that you've got in your arm. It's about the power that's in your legs. It's 10 times stronger than anybody's arms. So bang, in you go. Bang, in you go. Okay, practice that motor skill a little bit more. Okay guys, what we're going to do now is we're going to actually look at the palm heel with a partner. So your palm heel can be to the nose, it can be to the chin, okay, or it can be to the forehead. So the forehead, you actually go in taking the head all the way backwards. So whereas the pad is also tilting backwards, the head would too. Boom, like that. All right, okay. Right, I'm going to show you here. You know what? I want you to see the actual motor skills as well. So one, boom, straight through. All right, that's to the nose. Okay, boom, that's to the top of the head. Okay, boom, that's to the jawline. Now, the other one that I spoke about was the actual palm heel that came upwards. Now, this can be done from a very, very close quarters here. You're wrestling with them and it just comes straight up. All right, and that's what this one here is for here. It goes boom, yeah, takes the head clean, you're going into the chin and then taking the head all the way up, and your actual, the head's staying down here, but your hand is actually gone further over, right? And it comes all the way from your legs and upwards. Very powerful. What we're going to be looking at now is a hand system called scratch. First of all, let's just take the hands. We need to lock down that thumb again, just like we did with the palm heel. Right, but we need to flare the fingers. It's on both hands, right? And your main sort of attack points are your actual fingers. What you're going to be doing is you'll be going for the person's left eye, right eye, left eye. So left eye, right eye, left eye. Right? Your main area of attack will be, as you can see from the picture here, is going to be a diamond that goes from under the nose, up across the cheekbones, right, and then comes across this way. Right, so that's your main attack area. Right, so let's just turn to our left. So from a guard position, this would be done at a close range where somebody's come in on top of you and you haven't got a lot of room to move. This will give you the distance that you need. So the left hand comes up towards the eyes, it comes down. The right hand comes up towards the eyes, it comes down. The left hand comes up towards the eyes, comes down again. If somebody has backed you into a corner, this is the perfect way to get them to back. Just simply try it with a friend or a partner where you actually just touch their face. They automatically move backwards. They lean backwards, they push their head backwards, they stop looking at you. At this point, you'll be able to actually move them backwards. So one, two, three. So from a very, very sort of close range here, we've gone one, the head goes back. Two, the head goes back further. Three, they take a step back. Now from this point here, you can then attack with the elbows or sort of something like that. This is to gain space. You can't punch your way out of somebody coming towards you. This is simply to gain space. Okay, let me show you now on the pad and also on the actual person, the actual scratch techniques. So Andy's going to do the scratch techniques. First one is the left hand. It comes scratches side of the face. Second one, the right hand, scratches side of the face. And the third one, scratch this face. Yeah, each time that you do this, the person's face will move backwards. So if she was to do it to me, you would go here, okay? Then you would go here, then you would go here, okay? As I said, this is just for backing the person up, okay? So have a go there. Okay, if you've got a pillow or something like that, practice on there. So it's the one, two, three, right? One, two, three, right? Rotating, I'll face you when I do this. One, two, three. Okay, practice that. Enjoy.